So in the last few modules, we have seen that education policies have been prepared. Lots of targets have been promised, but most of these targets have not been achieved. So why this is so? Why government of Pakistan's education policies have failed? Why different reforms have failed? So in this module, we'll look at that. One of the major issues related to failure of education policies is finance or funding. So over the years, funding for education has increased, no doubt about it. But the way it should be increased, or the proportion by which it should have been increased, is not there. So Pakistan spends only between 2 to 3% of its GDP on education, which is quite less, and should be spending around 4%. And many governments have promised, even the last one too, that it will be increased to 4%, but it was not done. Second issue is lack of data. So if you don't have data, how many children are there, in which area they are there, how many teachers you are going to need in the next 5 years. If you don't have data, you can't plan. And if you plan without data, you fail. So that's one of the issues. During the last 10, 12 years, lots of progress have been made in terms of data, but still there are many areas in which data is not available, or if it's available, it comes very late, not good for planning. So that is another issue. Lack of consensus. So there are many different stakeholders that are involved in the preparation and implementation of school or education policy reforms. They are not consulted, or if they are consulted, their views are not taken into account, and that's why in the end they are not enthusiastic about these policies and the policies fail. Too many reforms. So Pakistan is one of in the last two decades one of those countries where lots of different reforms related to education policies has been done. So these reforms have the issue that if there are too many reforms, they sometimes contradict each other. So there are programs or reforms which are centralizing the education policy, and then there are programs which are trying to decentralize it. Then there is also lack of monitoring and evaluation. So if you don't, you are spending money, you are sending teachers, but if the teachers is not there, or somehow money is taken, there is pilferage of money, you will not succeed. There is also the issue of change of government. So governments change, and with them the policies change. And this leads to, of course, reforms that are unimplemented and targets that are unachieved. Then, of course, related to this political instability argument is the time given to reform implementation. So reforms are planned for example, 5 years and 10 years, and then when the government changes or some new reforms come in, without waiting for the earlier reforms to succeed, we jump on to new reforms, which of course leads to not achieving the targets, but failure to achieve the targets. Implementers, so the policies are made in Islamabad or Lahore or Karachi or Peshawar, but the actual work is done in districts and the seals, the education directorates, and they are not consulted at the time of policy making. So what happens is they don't know what to do, and they are given this task without explaining them why they are doing it. And that is another reason why policies fail. There is lack of coordination between different tiers. For example, the local government, the provincial government, the federal government. Another issue is parents don't see the benefits of education. So if there is no economic growth, not much employment available, why should parents send their children to school? Then there are cultural issues, for example, in women or female education or girls' education. Because of our culture, many parents think that, you know, they should not send their daughters to school, or if the school is far away, they will not, they want to send it, but they will not send it because of culture issues. And then there is, of course, crime, violence, terrorism, insurgencies, all these also affect the education targets achievement. So if you look at Balochistan, most of the targets have not been achieved in Balochistan, and one of the reasons there is that this area has always been or more recently have been a target, an area where insurgents are operating. Then there are priorities of the government. So if you look at, we decided as a nation, or Pakistani state decided, that we are going to be a nuclear nation. And even when all the world powers and everyone was against it, we did it. So we could have given the same priority literacy, but we didn't do it. Then, of course, there's the overpopulation. If there's too much population, you have this problem. Another issues are medium for instruction, madrasas, and non-formal education.